Now from this menu, if you press HH right arrow NK, something will happen. Hey guys, GetLevel here, and I don't think I've ever made a video about Discord. In this video, I'm gonna show you some of my favorite tips and tricks and Easter eggs on the app. I actually run my own Discord server. If you wanna join, the link will be in the description. I also stream on Twitch. Go follow me on Twitch, twitch.tv/GetLevel. I'm pretty excited for this video, but right before we start, a message from our sponsor. And this video sponsor is NordVPN. Yes, the NordVPN. Except, this time, it's their partnership program for Discord server owners. To keep it simple, if you have more than 50 members in your Discord server, you can sign up for the NordVPN partner program and start making money with your server. They will provide the assets to put in your Discord, and if anyone signs up to NordVPN, you're actually getting a cut, and a big cut. You'll get access to a dedicated account manager, and on top of that, they will do product giveaways. Basically, you will get access to free NordVPN accounts that you can give away to your community. So if you own a Discord server that has more than 50 members, you can sign up now at nordvpn.com/discord. Link will be in the description. Now, I cannot guarantee that those are tips, tricks, Easter eggs that you don't know, but a lot of them, I've only learned about them recently. So let's begin. Okay, first one, super easy. You can create folders for your servers. All you have to do is drag and drop them on each other, and boom, now you have your new folder. You can click on here, and if you click on them, it will expand and you will have a list of all the servers. If you right click, you will find folder settings. You can name this folder and also give it a custom color. Now this one is pretty well known. You can click on your profile picture and set a custom status. You can just put whatever you want and set it to clear after a certain amount of time. Today, 4 hours, 1 hour, 30 minutes, don't clear. Click save, and under your name now in the list, there will be your custom status. Okay, when it comes to emojis, you click on the emoji icon here to open the list, but if you want to add some favorites, you can hold alt on your keyboard and click on your favorite emojis. It will add them as your favorites. Now you have easy access to them. On the subject of emojis, you can add an emoji and add a plus before it in order to react to the latest message. Now, if you want to quickly edit a message that you just sent, you can just press the up arrow. From now, you can change whatever you're doing. You can press enter in order to save or escape to cancel. Now, if you want to add multiple reactions to one message at once, what you can do is click on add reaction, hold shift on your keyboard, and then just click on as many emojis as you want. That allows you to add so many reactions so fast. You can send an invisible message if you type 2 asterisks, space, 2 asterisks, enter. If you're setting up your server roles and you would like to see what people have access to more easily, you can go to your server settings, click on roles, select a role, and at the bottom here, you will see view server as role, and click here. You are currently viewing the server as the role. So if there are channels that they're not allowed to join or they're not allowed to see, you won't see them, etc. So top here, you can actually switch the roles. You can even add more roles just to have a better understanding of how you set up your own roles. You can disable that right here. In the text box, you can type a slash right here and you will have a bunch of suggestions. For example, /dad joke will get you a random dad joke. But that is just because of my bot. On the left here, you can select which bot you want to interact with the commands or just the built-in commands right here. For example, table flip will give you a table flip. If you're a content creator, you might want to add some links in your profile. So when someone right clicks on your profile, they can see your Twitch, your Twitter, your YouTube. And one way of doing this is by going to your user settings, going to connections top here. And from there, you can actually connect to all of those social platforms. Another advantage to having your Twitch, for example, connected to Discord is that you will gain access to certain servers based on if you're subbed or not, as you can see here. For example, I'm subbed to SweetXSage and I'm gonna join her server just based off of me being subbed. If you click on the Discord logo about 15 times, you should hear a sound. Discord. It took me more than 15 times, but from now on, every time you open Discord, you will hear this sound. If you want to deactivate it, just click a bunch of times again until you hear a disconnection noise. There you go. This one is well known, but if you click on your username multiple times, it will copy your username. But if you click it more and more and more, you're actually gonna get more messages. It usually stops at beyond godlike. If you don't want Discord to automatically change your text into emotes, for example, the smiley face, what you can do is go to your user settings, go to text and images, and under emoji, turn off this option. Now when you go back, there won't be an emoji. You can press Ctrl plus slash to get a list of all the shortcuts. Here, of course, you have all the shortcuts, but on top right, you will see a couple of arrows. Now, if you click on them, if you press the arrows on your keyboard, you can actually play some music. Now, from this menu, if you press HH, right arrow, NK, something will happen. There you go. And my favorite one is one that I haven't had the chance to experience myself because it's super rare. It's one revealed by Discord that you have a very small chance of hearing this ringtone when calling someone or being called by someone.
Discord Easter Eggs PT. One. There's a very small chance. And we mean very. Small chance. You'll get this secret ringtone when calling someone. Good luck.
And those were my favorite tips, tricks, Easter eggs for Discord. If there are any other cool ones that I didn't mention in the video, please let me know about them in the comment section below. Don't forget to follow me on Twitch, and if you're looking for some dope overlays to make your Twitch channel look good, go to gumroad.com/gallevel. A lot of them are free, the rest is very affordable. And if you're looking to make some cool animated gaming logos, you can get 15% off of playset.net by clicking on my link in the description. Top right, YouTube will show you what they think you should watch next, and at the bottom you will see my most recent video, so go check them out, keep on learning about everything. Go out there, make me proud, get a level, out.